Helicoprion. Any animal with the nickname Spiral Saw has got to be pretty badass. And the Helicoprion is no exception. Described by anthropologists as a whirl-toothed shark, this late carboniferous creature dominated the seas 280 million years ago, survived the cataclysmic Permian-Triassic extinction event, and eventually vanished out of our waters 225 million years ago during the first part of the Triassic period. During its oceanic reign, the Helicoprion subdued its prey with what only can be described as a circular saw of over 100 serrated teeth that expertly mashed up sea ammonite shells and ripped through the flesh of lesser fish. Helicoprion lived worldwide, with fossils unearthed in modern-day Russia, the northern United States, and Canada. Megalodon. The most infamous fish in all of recorded history, the Megalodon was a nightmarish, gigantic shark that roamed the prehistoric seas. This apex predator died out roughly 3.6 million years ago, although some speculate that these enormous sharks are still lurking in unexplored areas of our oceans, specifically the trenches that cut deep under our continents. The mighty Meg was astonishingly big, easily the biggest shark that ever existed at 60 feet long, or the length of 1.5 average-sized city buses. This giant animal was thrice the length of a great white shark and far more deadly. If that wasn't spine-chilling enough, consider the Megalodon's teeth. Every single tooth was an average of 7 centimeters long, or longer than a dollar bill, and this epic shark had 276 of them. Along with enormous serrated barbs, the Megalodon has a vast maw that could stretch up to 12 feet, enough to swallow 2 average-sized humans lying side by side in one gulp. This sadistic shark feasted on other sharks, whales, dolphins, and substantial lizard-like creatures of the ancient seas. Although modern-day pop culture paints the Meg as a supersized copy of today's great white shark, this creature resembled a blue shark with long pectoral fins, the better to ambush its watery prey. Kronosaurus. Named after the brutal Greek titan Kronos, Kronosaurus was a nightmarish marine reptile from the Cretaceous period. A massive plesiosaur, Kronosauruses averaged 30 feet long, or the length of 2 cars parked bumper to bumper. It was also a ruthless predator, swallowing up lesser lizards and small dinosaurs with equal zeal. Kronosaurus lived mostly near Queensland and northern Australia, and hunted by propelling itself forward with a pair of muscular flippers and snapping up prey with jaws full of 11-inch long teeth. That's a full 4 inches longer than your average megalodon teeth, making the animal one of the deadliest creatures that ever existed. It was also highly intelligent, and any prey that accidentally wandered into the Kronosaurus patch of ocean was in for a fatal surprise. Tylosaurus. Of all the Cretaceous Sea's deadly creatures, one stands head and shoulders above the rest, the mighty Tylosaurus. This marine reptile was as abundant as it was lethal, lurking everywhere from the Arctic Circle to the Gulf of Mexico. The Tylosaurus' secret weapon was its extra teeth, lodged in the interior of its skull. Tylosaurus already had plenty of razor-sharp teeth to mash up its prey. Still, the real death blow was delivered when the unfortunate animal was inside the monster's jaws and at the mercy of Tylosaurus' additional teeth. Tylosaurus used the sheer brute force of its snout to stun prey before skewering them on its rows of barbed teeth, ambushing from beneath. The 1-2 punch of their signature attack made them fierce fighters, but their sheer size made them absolute nightmare fuel. Tylosaurus could grow as large as 45 feet, or longer than your average 3-story building is tall. Today, you can find Tylosaurus' descendants in Southeast Asia, known as the humble monitor lizard. Leviathan. Leviathan was an ancient cannibalistic whale that might have inspired sea monster lore and certainly terrorized any prehistoric animals unfortunate enough to get near it. The Leviathan's favorite stomping ground was the Peruvian coast near the vast Atacama Trench, where it viciously dominated the seas 12 million years ago. Unlike today's sperm whales, the closest modern equivalent of Leviathan, this animal had powerful jaws and plenty of teeth to grind prey to paste. Each tooth was a full foot long and 4 inches wide, as long as a ruler and twice as wide. They are the biggest teeth that ever existed on any known animal, ever, including tusks. Also, unlike today's whales, Leviathan didn't rely on suction to draw in prey. It merely grabbed it in its cavernous maw and smashed it to bits. This animal was at the top of the food chain, a considerable feat when you consider what other kinds of powerful creatures lived in the ancient seas, and even ate baleen whales, a distant cousin, and other weaker, smaller leviathan. Dunkleosteus. The Dunkleosteus is what you get when you cross an enormous prehistoric fish with an armored tank. This swimming terror lived in the late Devonian period and was 33 feet long on average, and weighed as much as 4 tons. For reference, that's longer than a Cessna plane. If you crossed paths with this giant beast 400 million years ago, you were in big trouble. Its body was perfectly shielded in massive bone plates, giving it a serious evolutionary advantage over other animals of the time. On top of it all, the Dunkleosteus was carnivorous, voraciously consuming virtually any other fish in the seas, plus other Dunkleosteus. Although it was technically toothless, this powerful fish had an armored jaw that acted like a pair of sharp gardening shears, snipping its prey into tiny smithereens with ease. To boot, the Dunkleosteus had a 21,000 PSI bite capacity, which rivaled the ancient giant crocodile. Odontocalus semitestacea. Ancient China's Odontocalus semitestacea lived 220 million years ago and is a fascinating link between prehistoric animals and modern-day turtles. This amazing animal had a shelled belly, but its back was completely exposed, making it a cute and curious missing link. Turtles are the only animals that form shells on their bodies, and a turtle's shell is actually part of its ribs and vertebrae. Odontocalus semitestacea gives us some insight into how and why turtles forge their back shells. And the more we can study their remains, the more we can unravel the mysteries of one of nature's most enigmatic creatures. Ammonite. Mollusks from the dawn of time, ammonites are the ancient relatives of octopi and squid, and saturated the seas long before the first dinosaur ever set a scaly foot on the planet. Ammonites date back 400 million years and are very valuable as index fossils, or markers that paleontologists can use to determine how old rock formations are. Since our land and seas have shifted so much since the beginning of life on Earth, ammonites are one of the most valuable marine animals that ever existed. They were pretty cool for their time as well. Unlike modern-day octopi and squid, ammonites were hard-shelled but still had all the defense mechanisms of today's creatures, like tentacles and the capacity to squirt ink at predators. The name ammonite comes from the Egyptian sun god Amon. Elasmosaurus. This long-necked plesiosaur was a real-life sea monster, with a neck that stretched a full 20 feet. That's as long as a large SUV. These ancient animals had more neck bones than any other creature, then or since, with 72 vertebrae making up its diaphanous neck. Although creatures like Elasmosaurus are often depicted with bendy, S-shaped necks in pop culture and mythology, the real-life version is unlikely to have had this capacity. In reality, Elasmosauruses were probably not very flexible at all, but that hardly made them worse hunters. These animals could propel themselves through the seas using powerful flippers and crush prey with their sharp teeth. Although the Elasmosaurus ate mostly fish, its sheer size could have allowed it to consume smaller dinosaurs or even other plesiosaurs. Liopleurodon. Europe's apex sea predator, the Liopleurodon, was an artful ambusher who spanned 21 feet, or was as long as a giraffe is tall. Its name is Greek for smooth-sided teeth, but they might have been better off calling this apex predator carnivorous crushing teeth, because this voracious creature loved to snack on all of the goodies in the ancient world. Its diet included a mixture of fish, squid, and smaller marine reptiles. Like most formidable sea reptiles of the ancient world, the Liopleurodon probably also snacked on smaller dinosaurs. What really set this animal apart from the pack was its incredible speed. The Liopleurodon could not only swim exceptionally fast, but it was also intelligent enough to lurk near its prey and dart up from the darkness to ambush it, giving the Liopleurodon the element of surprise and the evolutionary boon of might. Spinosaurus. Once thought a land mammal, the Spinosaurus surprised paleontologists by revealing itself to be both a titan of the seas and shore. A colossal carnivore with the skull of a crocodile and the body of a T-Rex, except a lot more agile in the waves, using its enormous muscular tail as a propeller to navigate through the water. Spinosaurus lived during the Cretaceous period and was a whopping 50 feet long, or the length of your average giant squid. It enthusiastically hunted prey from both the land and the shallows, and one of its favorite meals was the ancient sawfish. The mere fact that the Spinosaurus could transition between land and sea meant that no creatures in its vicinity were safe. It was undoubtedly one of the apex predators of its time. Thanks for watching. Would you rather take a dip with a Leviathan or wrestle a Dunkleosteus? Let us know in the comments section below.